software update I have been eagerly awaiting. This is 2019.16.1. I was previously on 2019.12.1.1. So let's take a look, because I'll show you one of the big features that I really was waiting for, that I should say looking forward to. Now, for number one, we got driving visualization. The driving visualization has been adjusted to automatically zoom in and out to better utilize screen space and inform you when a vehicle is detected in your blind spot. The visualization remains zoomed out when driving on highways. And this is actually, it was really kind of neat, as the actual car moves left and right. It just doesn't show a car facing forward for your vehicle, I mean what you're sitting in driving. And it also rotates that, and the faster you go, the smaller the car gets to show more of what's going on around you, as well as when other vehicles came around. So take a look in the in one of the corners, because I got a little overlay of that in action, limited action at the moment. Then we got Sentry mode improvements. It is now easier to enable or disable Sentry mode by tapping the Sentry mode icon at the top of your touchscreen when your car is in park. That would be right there. On, off. On, off. Very cool. Now let's also, your car can also default Sentry mode to always be enabled when your vehicle is parked, by going to control, safety, blah, 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 security on. Okay, so let's just do that. So we got control, safety, and security. Sentry mode, we can turn that on. We can exclude home. You can exclude work. And now those, of course, have to be, those addresses need to be programmed into your nav to be excluded, and then you can also exclude favorites. So any addresses you save in your favorites for navigation can be excluded as well. So what's the point of having Sentry mode on in most cases if you're in your own home garage, or if you're parked at work in front of, you know, dozens of security cameras, or right outside your office window where you can see it constantly, you know? Because remember, Sentry mode does prevent the car from going into a deep sleep, causing the vampire losses of power. So that's kind of cool. I'm going to leave it off for now. I prefer to do it manually based on my power requirements. Software update preference. You now have the option to receive new software updates as soon as they become available for your car. Configuration and region. Tap controls, blah, 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 blah. So controls, and we go to software. We're on it already. And software update preferences. Standard, that's what pretty much everybody's used to and for the most part on right now, unless you have the early access program. You go to advanced and you get the software update as soon as it's available for your geographic area and trim level. So Ecto One will regularly receive over-the-air software updates to add new features and enhance existing functionality. Select advanced if you'd like Ecto One to receive new software updates as soon as they become available for its configuration. And I can imagine most people are just gonna select advanced. I mean, why not? Unless you're like me and you're trying to keep a vehicle on firmware 8, or in other words, my Model S, because it gets almost no benefit from firmware 9, and I really still hate the configuration and user interface of firmware 9. And I'm not going to stop complaining about it until they actually do something to improve firmware 9. And Swedish language support. While it's not something I need, it is available, so your touchscreen and navigation voice guidance is now available in Swedish. To change the language, simply go to Controls, Display, Language or Navigation, Language, well, in park. So we'll go to display, language, navigation language, English, Spanish, French, Canadian. Oh, wow. I didn't realize they had all these on here. Italiano. I might switch it to Italian just for fun. Oh, but that's written navigation, but I don't see Swedish. Unless it wasn't spoken. But no, it's navigation language. It doesn't show Swedish. Huh. Well, maybe that's a bug. So that is it for this firmware release, and of course it shows the other release notes, previous release notes as well, which was a update to navigate on autopilot, on route battery warm up, which I found out since my Model S is in for service, because the whole car just decided to go dead on me, and I had to remove my CAN bus what cable. It does fit on my Model X, so I can start showing battery data from my Model X, and we're going to do an on-route battery warm-up video once I get a cold enough day to do it. It's been in the 70s. Well, it's 48 right now, but I don't have time to go to a supercharger today. Software updates. Now it shows you the little bar. Tesla Atari, Sentry Mode, additional language support, and auto steer stoplight warning. So that's what I got for you. Take it or leave it. And life is short. Enjoy the ride. Wheelandsprocket.com. Never mind.